Hey guys, what's up? It's Rachel back with another video, and in today's video I'm going to be filming something that I've done here a lot on my channel. I love to take high-end eyeshadow palettes that are very popular and dupe them, so that's exactly what I'm going to be doing today. If you guys would like I said before, I have done a lot of these videos here on my channel. It's one of my favorites. It's probably one of my most filmed besides an actual makeup haul, so if you'd like to go check those out, definitely do so, because I have a lot of them. I've talked about a lot of very popular eyeshadow palettes that I have duped. So I don't think I have any updates in this video, except recently I was at Ulta. I think I went yesterday and I ended up picking up the Alyssa Edwards palette. This was definitely on my list. It was one that I definitely knew when I saw it that I wanted it. I'm just an Anastasia collector, and I have done a video talking about all of her palettes and why I am not so impressed all the time with Anastasia. I feel like I always have to have the newest Anastasia palette because they're so hyped up in this beauty community. If you want to know my opinions on the Anastasia palettes, definitely go watch that video. But I wanted to mention that I did grab this palette. I did post a picture of this on my Instagram. If you want to follow me on Instagram, it's Rachel_Hayes19. Just to let you guys know, because I do post when I buy new makeup products. I was lacking on that here lately. I haven't been posting when I purchase new makeup products, if anything. I've just been hauling them and talking about them in videos, but I'm trying to get back to that. But this is what the palette, again, looks like on the outside. It's very, very bright. It's very me. I love this packaging. I thought it was funny that a lot of people was talking about how Mandy's palette looked like this with the eyes, and it was supposed to be a drag palette as well. It's Life's a Drag, and this palette is in collab with a drag queen. When you open it up, this is what it looks like on the inside. This pink is the first thing that I see when I opened it up, this pink and this blue. I know a lot of people would probably say this yellow, but it's all very bright. You do have a few like transition shades and neutrals, but I'm very excited to play with this and see what I can come up with. When you look at this, you may be a little intimidated. I know that I kind of am. I'm not new to makeup. I kind of know what to put together and things like that, and I like to challenge myself and be creative, but this one kind of does it for me. Like, I am a little intimidated, but I am excited to play with this. And if it is something that you would like to see in a video, please let me know. Now, when it comes to these brushes, I used to like these brushes, but I did find that they shed like crazy. So what I did beforehand was I took this brush out and I was rubbing it on my hand, and I can see like the little bristles coming off. So these are poor quality made brushes, but if they didn't shed, they would be really nice, because like I said before, I have used these with my Eyelux. So that is a little bit of a bummer. Like, I wish they didn't shed, because they are pretty good brushes. But again, this is what it looks like, and if it's something that you want to see here on my channel, please let me know. Now we'll go ahead and get into the dupes. These are all high-end palettes duped. Now, their dupe may or may not be another high-end palette. Now, the reason I say that is because maybe I have a palette that is very popular, but it was poor quality, and I found another high-end palette that dupes it, but is much better in quality. So we're just going to go ahead and get started. The first palette I have to talk about is the Naked 3. I have talked about all the Naked palettes. I have a video on that as well. This to me was poor quality, but the colors in here were gorgeous, and I really wanted those light pale pinky shades. It lacked pigmentation. It was very stiff and chalky, and they did not blend well. And pretty much when I use this palette, I get the same look every time. All the colors, just they don't do much. Just so stiff and just chalky and lack of pigment. So this palette was a bummer for me, and this is very hyped up in the beauty community. The Naked palettes are, and in my opinion, like I said in that video, I feel like the only Naked palettes worth picking up are their newer releases in the newer packaging. The older ones aren't that great in my opinion. The reason I wanted to put this in the video was because I always wanted these light pale pinky colors like this, but I never could find it until recently. Now, I did haul the next palette I'm about to talk about. The dupe for the Naked 3 palette, if you're wanting colors to like this that perform really well, is the Huda Beauty New Nude palette. I love this palette. I have used it and I absolutely love it. It did not give me trouble at all. This is the little thingy in it that covers the eyeshadows. The mattes blend out so smooth. And when it comes to the mattes, when you layer the shadows, your transition shades, and then your darker shades to deepen up the crease, everything just layers so nicely. This is what the palette looks like, by the way. The shimmers are absolutely stunning. They are the colors that the Naked 3 palette tried to do. This is a straight on dupe for the Naked 3 palette, except these are so much better. So creamy, so blendable, and the shimmers are very wet looking on the lids. It looks absolutely gorgeous. I cannot say enough good things about this palette. This palette is very hyped up, and I can understand why. I have seen a lot of people talk about this palette, and for a while there, I wasn't really purchasing it because I remember when I first purchased my first Huda Beauty palette, it was the rose gold, and it was the original one, and it wasn't good at all. I didn't like it. I used it a lot just because I thought the colors were kind of unique, and it did give you that chunky glitter effect, but the quality just wasn't there, and it kindly strayed me away from Huda Beauty palettes for a while. But I saw so much hype surrounding this palette, and I tried it, and I absolutely love it. This is a must-have in your collection. If you're into colors like this, I'm telling you, they just blend out so well. If you are a beginner in makeup and you're someone looking for these colors, you definitely need this because this is one of those palettes that it's just kind of hard to mess up with. So again, this is what it looks like. Absolutely gorgeous. The next palette I have to talk about is from Too Faced, and this was a limited edition palette. I'm not sure if it's still up for sale or not, but I did want to talk about it because, again, it is limited edition. This is the Too Faced Pretty Mess with Erica Jane. This is the palette. This is what it looks like. Very cute packaging. And when you open it up, the first thing that you think of when you see this palette is, this is Modern Renaissance. And you're exactly right. The colors are exactly like Modern Renaissance, especially when it comes to the matte. This is what it looks like on the inside. You have pretty much everything you need. You have those berries and those like mauve shades. And it looks just like the Modern Renaissance. So that is the dupe for this. Again, this palette is limited edition, and the Anastasia one is permanent. And honestly, if I was going to pick one, I would definitely go with the Anastasia one. The quality on this is very, very nice. I do talk about how Anastasia's palettes are very powdery, and I'm kindly over that. Like, I don't like when it's so powdery. But I will say that this palette just gets me because the colors work out really nice for me. And I love the colors that they chose for this palette. I've used the crap out of this palette. It's one of my go-tos, and I can't say enough good things about it. The reason I wanted to put this in here as a dupe was because this is limited edition, and you can still get your hands on this. And this is actually better than this. The next palette I have to dupe is probably one that you may have heard of, but I have never talked about it here on my channel. The palette I'm going to talk about is the Tarte Toasted palette. This is what it looks like on the outside. And when you open it up, you have a mixture of shimmers and mattes. This is the only Tarte, like Tartlet palette that I like. I don't like In the Blooms, I think it's called, and I don't like the first one that has all cool tone mattes. That one is absolutely horrible. It's stiff and it's chalky, and I talked about that in a disappointing products video, but this one is pretty good. I will say it's not my favorite. Tarte is hit and miss when it comes to their eyeshadow palettes, just like with any brand, but I specifically like this one. This one's pretty good. Not bad, warm tone palette, very nice. You have everything that you need to get that strong warm tone look. So the dupe that I have for this, because this is pricey, it retails for like $40, $42, $45, somewhere around there. The dupe I have to talk about is from ColourPop, and this is the Double Entendre palette. I'm pretty sure I'm saying that right. This is what it looks like on the inside. It is seriously a straight up dupe for this palette. They look identical. I'm going to hold them up side by side so you can see. It's pretty much like they intended to dupe this palette. It's what it looks like to me because the colors are so similar. If you look in this row right here, I mean, it's just like, it's spot on. Even to the shimmers. Look at the white shimmer on the top there, and look at the one on the Tarte palette. I mean, it's just like spot on. Everything is exactly the same. And I have talked about ColourPop a lot here on my channel. I've done a video on ColourPop palettes. You cannot go wrong with their formula. They just blend out so easily, and the shimmers are very intense, and it's like high end quality for like paying like maybe just a little bit more than drugstore. I consider ColourPop to be drugstore in my opinion, but straight on, it is a dupe. If you're somebody that you don't want to pay the high price tag for the Tarte palette, I would definitely check this one out. You cannot go wrong with ColourPop palettes, but if you are somebody that you haven't really tried any of these Tartlet palettes, I would definitely go with this one because the other ones are not good in my opinion. The next palette I have to talk about is an Anastasia palette. This is a newer palette to them. This is the Revera palette. I think I'm saying that right, but this is what the packaging looks like. And then when you open it up, this is when Anastasia started coming out with their bright colors, which was kind of shocking to everybody because they really only stuck to their neutrals. But this is what it looks like on the outside. You have a gorgeous row of like shimmery metallic shades, and then the bottom row is just matte. Very, very nice, very pretty, very summery, like the brush just fell out, but very nice. One of my probably one of my favorites. I love this palette. When I look at this palette, my eyes go straight to that hot pink shade. It's very pretty. But the dupe that I have for this palette, if you're somebody that you don't want to spend the money on this, is the BH Cosmetics Weekend Festival palette. This was a very hyped up palette. A lot of people was talking about it during last summer. A lot of people wanted to get their hands on it. It was hard to for a while. It kept selling out on Ulta. This is what it looks like on the inside. You have the dupe for that pink right there. You have the dupe for that blue. Then you have a shade in there that's kind of like this. I mean, it's spot on, guys. And I'm gonna hold it up so you guys can kindly see what I'm talking about. This color right here, I'm going to give you a close-up. This color right here is a spot-on dupe for the color right here in this palette. And again, held up side by side, you can kindly see that this is a dupe. And you can always catch BH Cosmetics on sale. They go on sale a lot at Ulta's website. So if you're somebody that you know that you probably won't use those types of colors all the time, but you wanted to have them in your collection, I would definitely check out this one. Like I said, goes on sale a lot. I remember one time it was like $11 and something, and this one's pretty expensive. It's like $42, $45, something like that. So I definitely check this one out. And the last palette that I have to talk about is a palette that they don't make anymore. I don't think it's done that well, but it was very nice quality. It was the Urban Decay Naked Smoky palette. I personally love this palette. If I'm wanting a smoky look, I do reach for this palette. Again, the newer packaging palettes from Urban Decay, when it comes to their Naked line, these are so much better than their older packaging ones. This is what it looks like on the inside. You have shimmers, you have mattes, and you have everything that you need. I love that they put in not necessarily a black, but it's a navy blue that when you smoke it out, I mean, it's going to look black, but it does have that tinge of navy blue. I actually like that they didn't put a black in because it's so, like, it's pretty much what you would expect to see, a black. And I like that they put in a navy blue, but this is what it looks like. Sadly enough, they don't make this palette anymore. I had purchased mine for the original price. It was like $52 or $54. And then it ended up going on sale for like $20-something, and they completely took it off so that they didn't sell it anymore. And the palette that I have to dupe this is something that I don't use because I'm actually afraid of it. They're so smoky. I had got this in one of my BoxyCharms. It was a pre-made box. This is the Pretty Vulgar palette in the one called Nightingale. And this is what it looks like. I don't use this palette because they are so smoky that it scares me. But the reason that I wanted to put this in here is if you're somebody that you wanted a smoky palette and you couldn't get your hands on this one, I would definitely go with this one. The price on this is actually a little bit cheaper than the Urban Decay ones anyway. And these are so smoky and just very pigmented, very smooth, very soft to the touch. But I'm telling you, these are so smoky. And it does have a black in there as well. And just very strong gray tones and blue tones. And it scares me. I don't use this palette because they're so strong. I just go for this one if I'm going to do a smoky look. But if you're somebody that you like that, then you will definitely love this. And I feel like this is a dupe for this palette. So, but other than that, that is everything that I have to talk about. That is all the dupes that I have found so far. Again, please check out my other videos. I have done a lot of these and I've talked about a lot of palettes. I don't have anything else to update you guys with, except if you want me to do a review on the Alyssa Edwards palette with Anastasia Beverly Hills, then please let me know. I will definitely get that up for you guys. But other than that, I just want to thank you guys so much for watching. It honestly means the world to me, and don't think that you go unnoticed because I truly do see it and I really do appreciate it. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. But before you go, please don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell below so you are notified every time I upload a video. And also don't forget to follow me on Instagram because I post on there when I upload new videos and sometimes new makeup products. Again, I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video.